My God is good, oh.
Welcome out. My screen is not on. I can't see anybody, but I could feel the Holy Spirit. Welcome out. Double. Let's go. We're about to worship all our stress away in Jesus' name. We're about to worship all our problems away. We're not giving no authority to our problems in Jesus' name. Welcome out. Welcome out. Blessing and breakthrough. Welcome out. I see you, Ken. Welcome out. Blessing and breakthrough. Welcome out. We're casting in the spirit of defeat in Jesus' name. We're casting the spirit of doubt in Jesus' name. Your God is too good for that. Welcome out. Blessing and breakthrough. Welcome out. Go ahead and invite a friend. New way.
Amen.
Worship.
Amen.
Worship.
Welcome.
Worship.
To blessing and breakthrough.
It's been a minute. Worship. We're casting out all unclean spirits. We're casting out spirit of despair. We're casting out the spirit of depression. We're casting out the spirit of doubt. We're casting out the spirit of lack. We're casting out the spirit of divorce. We're casting out the spirit of desperation. We're casting out the spirit of separation. We're casting out the spirit of divorce. Welcome out the blessing and breakthrough. Welcome out. We're casting out the spirit of sickness. We're casting out the spirit of depression. We're casting out the spirit of unemployment. We're casting out the spirit of loneliness. We're casting out the spirit of insecurity. Hallelujah. Welcome out.
Welcome out.
Blessing and breakthrough, y'all. Go ahead and invite a friend. Shed a lie. Let's go. Invite an enemy. I don't care. Let's go. Worship. Understand that spirits are living beings. They need a certain environment for them to thrive. Don't give them that environment. So when you start worshiping, you are pushing out these unclean spirits. When you start worshiping, it doesn't matter who's doing witchcraft upon your life. It doesn't matter what demonic attack is happening on your life. Because once you are worshiping, you create an environment of fire. Holy Spirit, fire. The devil's attack cannot work. Your enemy's witchcraft attack cannot work. So I'm telling you right now, start worshiping. Start worshiping. Your enemies want you to be depressed. Your enemies want you to start doubting. Your enemies want you to give up, but understand that once you start worshiping, you create an environment where demons cannot thrive. You create an environment where witchcraft attack cannot thrive. So I'm encouraging you right now to start worshiping your problems away. Worship your depression away. Worship your despair away. Understand that when you are worshiping, you're inviting the spirit of blessing. When you are worshiping, you're inviting the spirit of elevation. When you are worshiping, you're inviting the spirit of breakthrough. So I'm telling you right now, worship your problems away. There's power and authority in worship. Worship brings in the spirit of faith. Worship brings the spirit of joy. Understand that your strength is in the joy of God. Hallelujah. Worship. Welcome out to Blessing and Breakthrough Sunday service. I'm your host, Pastor Mackinson Lewis. We got DJ Majesty on
welcome, the one and two.
Welcome out. Welcome out to Blessing and Breakthrough, y'all.
Yes.
Let's go.
Lord Jesus will provide his servant, Pastor Mackinson Lewis, to bring you his word and message tonight.
Worship.
There's no way. Jehovah has the final say.
Yes. We're about to get into our prayer, y'all. Yes, we're about to get into our prayer. Hallelujah. Yes. Let's go. We're about to get to our prayer segment. I'm excited to be back. It's been a minute. Have you allowed the devil to have victory over your life? Have you allowed the devil to steal your joy? Have you allowed the devil to steal your faith? It's time to take it back. Hallelujah. Welcome out. Blessing and breakthrough. Sunday service. Welcome out to Blessing and Breakthrough Sunday service. Hallelujah. Go ahead and tag a friend. Tag an enemy. This is the place to be. This is how you're going to start your week. This is how to start your week off right. You're going to move with the power and the authority of Jesus Christ. Understand that we are casting out all unclean spirits that are blocking your breakthrough. All unclean spirits that are blocking your elevation. We are casting them out right now in Jesus' name. Get excited. God is moving. I need you to come in here with expectancy. God is going to meet you at the crossroad of your needs. Hallelujah. You need to get excited about God. So understand that what you project onto God, he's going to send it right back. Jesus said, if you're ashamed of me, I will be ashamed of you. So understand that what you throw back at God, he's going to throw it right back at you. It's time for you to get excited, God. Make God your priority. He's going to make you a priority. Get excited. Get excited. Get excited. Get excited. Get excited. Whatever you're going to receive from God is going to be through faith. Faith is the highway. Faith is the highway. God utilized to deliver whatever he has for you. So we are going to step out faith today. We are going to step out faith today. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Get excited. Your best day are ahead of you, not behind you. Get excited, get excited. If you are in control of your life, then you can say your best days are behind you, because I'm not going to be as young as I used to be. I'm not going to be as strong as I used to be. But when you know God is in control, your best days are ahead of you. Your best days are ahead of you. So get excited. God is in control of my life, so I know my best days are ahead of me. Get excited. Get excited. If God is in control, if Jesus is in control of your life, that means your best days are ahead of you. If Jesus Christ is the head of your life, that means your best days are ahead of you. So get excited. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Go ahead and share the live. Go ahead and share the live. Ooh, we have a powerful sermon for you guys today. We're about to get into our prayer segment, and then we're going to jump into the sermon. So right now, I just need you to type in your prayer request. Type in your prayer request, and then we're gonna jump into the sermon. Woo! God is gonna change your life today. There's a monumental sermon tonight. God is gonna meet you at the crossroad of your needs. God have a special word for you tonight. So go ahead and tag a friend. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Brother Mingo is in the building. Brother Michael Mingo is in the building. Welcome out, brother. So understand that we're about to get into our prayer segment. So go ahead and type in your prayer request. If it is health, go ahead and type in health. We're gonna lift you up in prayer. If it is finance, go ahead and type finance. We're going to lift you up in prayer. If it's marriage, go ahead and type marriage. We're going to lift you up in prayer. And understand that once I attack a prayer and it address your needs, go ahead and raise your hand in the air and say, Lord, I receive it. Even if you were not the one that requested that prayer, but receive it. God is moving. God is moving right now. God is moving. The Holy Spirit is moving. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. So right now we are on Instagram. Right now we are on TikTok. Right now we're on YouTube. Hallelujah. So welcome out. Whatever platform you are on, welcome out. Hallelujah. Go ahead and text a friend that link and invite them to join us. Hallelujah. Get excited. Get excited. Get excited. The devil have taken too much from you. Get excited. Get excited. It's time to take back what the devil have taken from you. The devil have robbed you of your blessings. The devil have robbed you of your promotion. The devil have robbed you of friendships. The devil have robbed you. Enough is enough. It's time for you to put your foot down and said, I want everything the devil have taken from me. Enough is enough. Understand that. You don't need permission from the devil to be happy. You don't need permission from the devil. Understand that for you to be the very best you that you can be. Understand all you got to do is surrender to the power and the authority of Jesus Christ. So welcome out, welcome out, welcome out. Oh, right. Sister Tracy's dropped her prayer request. We're going to get into the prayer segment. Sister Tracy's praying for a stronger prayer life. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We're about to get into our prayer segment. And we're about to get into our prayer segment. The Holy Spirit is moving in a monumental way. Understand that people have been delivered. Oh, divorce, Heavenly Father. Marriage have been restored after divorce have been filed. People who are knocking at death's door, their health have been restored. God have broken the casket. So understand that. The Holy Spirit is moving in a monumental way. So go ahead and put your prayer request right now in the comment section and see if God won't blow your mind. It's been done before and he will do it again. We're about to go into our prayer segment. Oh, Sister Tracy placed the first prayer request. She asked for a strong prayer life. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. She could have asked for anything. She could have asked for anything, but she asked for a strong prayer life. She wants to be closer to her Lord and Savior. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Ooh, the Lord God say, ask and you shall receive. Let us go to the Lord. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, Lord, we lift Sister Tracy before you. Heavenly Father, Lord, she is asking for a strong prayer life because she knows, Heavenly Father, Lord, you have the answer to everything. And she knows, Heavenly Father, Lord, if she has you, she has everything. She wants to strengthen her bond with you. She wants to strengthen her connection with you, Heavenly Father, Lord. She wants to be one with your precious Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, Lord, she wants to live a God-centered life. She don't want to live a self-centered life, but she want to live a God-centered life, Heavenly Father. And she knows the only way to do that is through prayer. In any relationship, Heavenly Father, the more time you spend with that person, the more you get to know them, the closer you get to them, Heavenly Father. So she knows, Heavenly Father, there's no way around this, Heavenly Father. She wants to get closer to you, Heavenly Father. She wants to be more intimate with you, Heavenly Father. She wants to be one with your precious Holy Spirit. So I lift Sister Tracy's prayer life before you, Heavenly Father. I speak a supernatural anointing over her prayer life, Heavenly Father, where she will be able to pray, Heavenly Father, and intercede, Heavenly Father, and her prayers will be answered, where she would pray, Heavenly Father, and a shift will take place, where she will be able to pray, Heavenly Father, for the deaf, they'll be able to hear. She'll be able to pray for the mute, they'll be able to speak. She'll be able to pray for the crippled, they'll be able to walk. She'll be able to pray for the sick, and they will get well, Heavenly Father. Oh, Lord, I speak a supernatural anointing over her prayer life, Heavenly Father. Mold her into the praying warrior that she wants to be, Heavenly Father, so you, Heavenly Father, can execute your power, your authority, and your glory through this woman of God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Welcome out to our prayer segment, y'all. Welcome out to our prayer segment. All you got to do is put your prayer request in the comment section, and we are going to address it. And the God is going to move right now. Right now, it doesn't matter what device or you are on, the Holy Spirit is moving through these devices right now, whether it's a laptop, iPad, cell phone. God is moving, the Holy Spirit is moving. It doesn't matter what you're going through, understand that your problem does not surpass the power and the authority of Jesus Christ. It doesn't matter if it's sickness, it doesn't matter if it's divorce, it doesn't matter if it's legal problem. Oh, you are looking at someone that should have been dead long time ago, but understand that I surrender to the power and the authority of God, and Jesus restored my health. So understand that when it was time for my parents to go casket shopping, God said, no. And God restored my health. So the same God that executed this miracle over my life, he can execute the same miracle over your life. He is in the miracle making business. So understand that impossible is nothing for Jesus Christ. So go ahead and put your prayer request right Amen. Now in the comment section. And God is going to meet you at the crossroad of your needs. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, we have another prayer request. Praying to remove distractions when trying to read my Bible and study and be able to pass my classes. Oh, Jashard 8. Amen, 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 amen. Understand that the devil knows the power of the Word of God. That is why you could watch hours of television. You could scroll on social media for hours. You could be on the phone having endless conversations with your friends. But the moment you open your Bible, what happens? You get sleepy. What happens? You get fatigued, because the devil don't want that kind of problem. Because now you are arming yourself. Now you're having power and authority, and you are able to blast these demons to smithereens. So he doesn't want you to have that authority. So that's why he used distraction to stop you from reading your Bible. So we are going to pray against spiritual laziness in Jesus' name. Ooh, the Holy Spirit is moving in a monumental way. People are praying for stronger prayer life. People are asking for a stronger Bible study life. So God is moving in a monumental way. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Oh, Jashard 8, we're going to pray for you as well as anyone who is struggling with their Bible study life and that is struggling with the spirit and the demons of distraction. Oh, if that is you, all you got to do is raise your hand in the air and say, Lord, I receive it. Let us go to the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Lord, we lift Jashard 8 before you, Heavenly Father. You know his government. We lift them before you, and all every individual who have their hands up, Lord, who is struggling, Heavenly Father, with the spirit of distraction. Every individual, Heavenly Father, who is struggling, Heavenly Father, with reading their Bible daily, Heavenly Father, that are unable to be consistent with their Bible study. Lord, we are casting out, Heavenly Father, the demons of spiritual laziness. Oh, Heavenly Father, every individual who have a hand up right now, Heavenly Father, oh, Lord, I speak a special anointing over their Bible study life. Allow them to study their Bible every single day. Allow them to read their Bible every single day, Heavenly Father. Allow them to memorize scriptures on a regular basis, Heavenly Father. Oh, Lord, allow them to have a strong spiritual life, Heavenly Father. Oh, Lord, allow them to be on fire for you. No matter how busy they are, they will make time, Heavenly Father, for them to study their Bible. They will make time, Heavenly Father, for them to memorize the scripture, for them to read their Bible on a daily basis, Heavenly Father, no matter how busy or how full their schedule may be, Heavenly Father. They will always put time aside for you. They will make you their priority, Heavenly Father, because the scripture says faith comes by hearing. Allow them, Heavenly Father, to read the word out loud every single day, Lord, for them to feed their faith and for them to get closer and press towards you, Heavenly Father. Oh, Lord, so we ask deliverance, Heavenly Father, over the demons of spiritual laziness, over the lives of every single individual, Heavenly Father, that have their hands up right now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Amen. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, praise hallelujah. Oh, yes, 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 yes. Ooh, some kind come out of by fasting and prayer. Absolutely, absolutely. Certain demons you cannot cast out through prayer alone, but you have to cast them out through prayer and fasting. Amen. Woman of God. Amen. Right now we're about to get into a prayer for health. Anyone who's battling any form of sickness and illness, any kind of disease, this prayer is for you. If you're dealing with any form of discomfort, pain, all you got to do is raise your hand in the air and say, Lord, I receive it. The Holy Spirit is moving right now. If you have your hand up, understand that. Prepare for a miracle. Prepare for a supernatural healing over your body. I don't care what the sickness is. I don't care what the illness is. Understand that God is not limited by your sickness. It doesn't matter if it's cancer. It doesn't matter if it's HIV or AIDS. It doesn't matter if it's heart disease. It doesn't matter if it's kidney failure, prostate failure. It doesn't matter what the disease is. All you got to do is to raise your hand in the air and say, Lord, I receive it. And watch the miracle happen in your life. Understand that the Bible spoke of the time and when the angel of God would go through the river of Jordan and turn it, and anyone who jumped in it will be free of all sickness and disease. So understand that the Holy Spirit is moving right now. Anyone who raised their hand in the air right now, understand that the Holy Spirit is going to heal you of any sickness, any disease. All you got to do is come back next week and testify what God has done in your life. God don't need your money. He needs your heart. He needs you to surrender. He needs you to believe. He needs you to trust. So raise your hands in the air right now. If you're suffering from any sickness, any diseases, any pain, any discomfort, I need you to raise your hand in the air and prepare for a miracle. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, Lord, we lift every individual that have their hand up right now. We are casting out all cells of sickness and diseases over their lives in Jesus' name. We're casting out, Heavenly Father, with the spirit of cancer in Jesus' name. It doesn't matter if it's stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, or stage 4. I cast out the spirit of cancer in Jesus' name. I cast out the spirit of tumors in Jesus' name. I cast out all sexual transmitted diseases in Jesus' name. It doesn't matter if it's herpes. It doesn't matter if it's chlamydia. It doesn't matter if it's HIV or full-blown AIDS. I speak a complete healing over your body in Jesus' name. I cast out the spirit of diabetes in Jesus' name. I cast out the spirit of heart diseases in Jesus' name. I cast out the spirit of kidney failure in Jesus' name. I cast out the spirit of depression in Jesus' name. I cast out the spirit of suicide in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I cast out the spirit of failing eyesight, of failing hearing. I cast that out in Jesus' name. I cast out the spirit of arthritis in Jesus' name. I cast out the spirit of blood disease in Jesus' name. I cast out all respiratory diseases in Jesus' name. I block all demonic witchcraft attack over your life in Jesus' name. I speak restoration over your life. I speak blessing over your life. Those who are under attack, where your finances are being attacked, I speak deliverance over your life in Jesus' name. Those who are under attack, that are unable to get married, that have spirit spouses, I speak deliverance over your life. Oh, in Jesus' name, you will get married. In Jesus' name, you will get married. And those that are already married, well, your marriage is under attack. You look like you're going to get divorced. I break that in Jesus' name. Oh, by the power of Jesus Christ, I speak restoration over your marriage. I speak healing over your marriage. I speak deliverance over your marriage. Oh, those who have conflict in their family where they're never able to have any unity, I speak unity. I speak love. I speak grace. I speak forgiveness. I speak restoration over your family in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Ooh, this is the promise. This is the promise. Hallelujah. 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 Yes. Oh, I need you to walk by faith and not by sight. It doesn't matter what you see. So understand that. Oh, you serve the one and only true living God that can do all things but fail. So it doesn't matter what men say. It doesn't matter what science say. It doesn't matter what the so-called experts say. Stand on the authority of Jesus Christ and he will see you through. Stand on his promise. He said he will never forsake you. So understand that God is with you at all time. Know it. Trust it. Believe it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're about to get into our word, y'all. We're about to get into our word. Get your Bible. Get your notepad. Oh, man. God is awesome. God is perfect.
Amen. Amen to
hallelujah,
that.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Get your Bible, get your Bible, get your Bible. So today's word is going to be short in length, but not in power. So get your Bible, get your Bible, get your Bible. Hallelujah. I'm excited. I'm excited. Oh, man, I'm excited. I'm excited. I'm excited. Get your Bible, get your notepad. DJ Majesty's about to read our sermonic scripture, and then we're going to dive into the word. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise welcome God. Out, welcome praise out, God. KB, welcome out. Seed Vige, welcome out. Sister Tracy, welcome out, y'all.
Share the live, guys. Share the live.
Let's go. Let's go.
Someone else will be blessed and have their spirit uplifted in the Lord Jesus Christ. So I will be reading from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 14 to 16. The word of God goes like this. You are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand. And it gives light to all who are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Praise the Lord Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The title of our word for today is Deliverance from Brokenness and Darkness. Deliverance from brokenness and darkness. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. So understand that the devil knows when he breaks you, now you're going to operate in brokenness. And he knows now you will not be able to receive the blessing that God has for you. So now he traumatized you. So understand that. That's why you see people are dealing with depression. That's why you see people deal with anger issues. It's because something happened. Understand that a lot of times, if you study psychology, they'll tell you when someone is traumatized, violated at a certain age, it blocks their maturity. So that person gets stuck, and that's what trauma does. That's what brokenness does. So you would see Michael Jackson, he was molested at a certain age, and you see that the maturity just stopped at that particular age. He never developed maturity after that, never developed emotional maturity after that, because that trauma blocked him and he became stuck at that time period, at that age. So that's what trauma does. That's what brokenness does. So it's there to rob you of your future blessings. It's there to rob you of your elevation. So I'm here to let you know it's time for you to be delivered from your darkness. It's time for you to be delivered of your brokenness, because that's what the devil wants. He put traps along the way to make sure that you don't attain the level that God wants you to attain, so you don't walk into the promised land that God has for you. So understand that. You ever seen people, you just dismiss that person. Oh, that's an angry black woman. Oh, that's an angry black man. But you don't know the trauma that this person has gone through, that this person has experienced. It's just like if you have a dog. A dog has been violated and abused. So now when the dog get a loving home, that dog is even though that dog has experienced love, but that dog is unable to receive that love. That dog is liable to bite the person that's loving them. Why? Because of the trauma that dog experienced. So that trauma is stopping that dog from receiving a loving home. So understand, the same thing happens to us. So you can allow your trauma from receiving a loving wife. You can allow your trauma to block you from receiving a loving husband. So understand that a good man is not going to put up with all the trauma, all the brokenness. So it is your job and your job alone to align with God and to be healed of your brokenness, to be healed of your darkness. Whether you're a man or a woman, it is your job. Understand that. Otherwise, you are going to make your future spouse, you're going to make the people in your present pay for the attack of those that violated you in the past. And that's going to block your blessing. So understand that people are not just going to put up with your nonsense. Eventually, they are going to leave. They are going to break away from you. So the first thing you got to do now to break away from all trauma and brokenness is you got to acknowledge it. Don't suppress. Don't dismiss. You have to acknowledge it. Okay, this person did that to me. But I forgive you. But I love you. But I'm going to pray for you. And when you are doing that, that's when you are going to heal. Because the devil is going to justify, hey, you have the right to be angry. You have the right to be upset. And while you are doing that, what's happening is you are staying in the spirit of victimization. And you will be a victim. And when you are walking around being a victim, you are walking around being wounded. All you are going to attract is abusers. All you are going to attract is users, because they see the brokenness in you and they're going to take advantage of that. You ever watch National Geographic? Whenever an animal is bleeding, is wounded, so what happened? The predators come out. If you go into the water and you are bleeding, what's going to happen? The shark are going to come out. So it's the same thing. If you're walking around broken, wounded, you are going to attract abusers. You're going to attract users. So you are not ready for you to receive the man or the woman that God has for you. It is your job for you to heal right now. It is your job for you to heal right now. You got to start forgiving all those who violated you. You have to start loving all those who have wronged you. You have to heal right now. Otherwise, you will not Receive the blessing that God has for you. So understand that it's time for you to break away from the brokenness. It's time for you to break away from the darkness, for you to be the man or the woman of God that you are called to be.
Amen.
It's time for you to receive your blessing. So understand that. And if you see that you are still struggling forgiving, while you, here's the first secret to forgiving those who have wronged you. Pray for them every day. Pray for them every day. So as you're praying for God to bless them, as you're praying for God to heal them, because understand that whoever violated you, they were violated themselves. So understand that hurt people hurt people. Understand that. That's why when you are not healed, you and you are damaged, you are going to damage someone else. That's why those who are molested become molesters, because they were never got healed. So they pass the trauma on to someone else. So understand that if you are not healed, you're going to pass your damage on to your future spouse. You're going to pass your trauma on to your future kids. So it is your responsibility for you to get healed right now. It is your responsibility for you to forgive those who have hurt you right now. It is your responsibility for you to find the peace of Jesus Christ right now. Otherwise, you are going to be hurting those that love you. And people are not going to keep putting up with you hurting them while they're trying to love you. People are not going to put up with you hurting them while they are trying to love you. People are not going to put up with you pulling them down while they're trying to pull you up. Eventually, they're going to say enough is enough. And you're going to end up dying alone. I used to work in a nursing home, and I would see certain people, they would have visits because they just have so much love in them, and people just love being around them. They would constantly get visits, and I would see certain old people, nobody would visit them. They would be sitting by the window, just alone, just miserable, just lonely. Why? Because that person lived a life of brokenness. This person never got healed. This person never seeked the love of Jesus Christ. So understand that the devil's going to tell you, you have every right to be angry. You have every right to be bitter. You have every right, but he's telling you to hold on to a spirit of victimization. Don't do that. You serve the one and only true living God. You're nobody's victim. You serve the one and only true living God. You are not a victim. Understand the magnitude of the God that you serve. God said all things work for the glory of those who are called and truly love the Lord. So that means he will use everything that you have gone through to bless you. He will use everything that you have gone through to elevate you. He will use everything that you have gone through to pull you closer to him. So understand that nothing you have gone through surpassed the authority of God. So all you got to do is surrender. Surrender your problems to God and start loving those who have hurt you. Start praying for those who have harmed you. And once you are praying for them consistently, once you are wishing for God to bless them, understand that's going to push out the spirit of anger. It's going to push out the spirit of animosity. It's going to push out the spirit of grudges. It's going to push out the spirit of unforgiveness. So start now. Start now. Loving your enemy. That's the secret. Jesus gave you the secret. Jesus is the teacher. So why would you not listen to the teacher? The mistake that we make is that we are copying off the of the dumb kids. We're copying off society. Society's failing. Society's miserable. Society's depressed. Society's broken. So why would I not follow the teacher? Jesus is the teacher. Amen. So Jesus said, this is the way for peace. This is the way for you to find joy. Forgive your enemies. So why would you give your enemies authority over your joy? Why would you give your enemies authority over your happiness? So who are you hurting when you do that? You. That's it. You're hurting no one else. So understand that forgiveness has nothing to do with your enemies. Forgiveness is all about you. You are blocking your blessings. You are blocking your blessings by not forgiving your enemies. You are blocking your blessing. You're blocking your peace. You're blocking your joy. You're blocking your elevation by not loving and forgiving your enemies. So understand that. So if you are smart, you will start forgiving and start loving your enemies right now. Yes. I pray for those who tried to kill me every single day. I pray for those who have tried to kill me every single day. I used to be married from a family of straight up devil worshipers. My in-laws tried to kill me, and I pray for my mother-in-law every day. I pray for my father-in-law every day. And in Jesus' name, they're going to get saved. Understand that. That's the message I sent to the devil. Anyone that you send after me, they're going to get saved in Jesus' name. And you're going to lose the investment. You're going to lose what you have invested in these people. And they're going to be soldiers and warriors in God's army. That's how you fight the devil back. Understand that you do not battle against flesh and blood, but against spirits and principalities. So again, understand that you are not at war with any individual. You are at war with the spirit that this individual have aligned with. Hallelujah. So understand that. You are moving like a white belt believer. If you're thinking that you are your enemy's a person. No, it's the spirit that this person have aligned with. That's who you are at war with. You are at war with spirits. and principalities. So understand that you're not at war with your mother. You're not at war with your father. You're not at war with your coworkers. You're not at war with your neighbors. You're not at war with your in-laws. You are at war with demons. So understand that. So the moment you start looking at people, the devil won. The devil won. You're bringing a knife to a gunfight. The devil won. Once you start looking at people, don't look at people. You are at war with demons. So that's the first step. Understanding the spiritual realm. Understand, I counsel a lot of people. They were not able to get married. But after counseling, boom, within a short period of time, they're able to get married. So understand, there are principalities, there are spirits at play. There to stop you from your blessing. There to stop you from your elevation. There to stop you from your breakthrough. So your job is not to create an environment for demons to thrive. Not to create an environment for demons to prosper. So understand that. Understand that. We have allowed our trauma to align us with demons. So when you go through a trauma, the devil used that to get into your life. You ever seen people that go from 0 to 100? They get angry so quick. What do you think happened? They psychology say, oh, this person have multiple personality. This person aligned with the demon as a defense mechanism. So now no one is going to hurt me anymore. No one is going to attack me anymore. So at any given moment, this person could snap. What do you think that is? That's a defense mechanism because of the trauma this person experienced. So understand that when you are dealing with demons, you are going to block your blessing. Let go of all these demonic forces. It's time for you to experience the joy of Jesus Christ. It's time for you to experience the peace of Jesus Christ. It's time for you to forgive the person who molested you. It's time for you to forgive that person who raped you. It's time for you to forgive that person that took your that robbed you. That person who you lent money and never gave it back. It's time for you to forgive your mother. It's time for you to forgive your father. Yes, they mistreated you. Your mother-in-law, that father-in-law. Yes, they violated you. Yes, they manipulated you as a child. But understand that you're hurting no one else but you by holding on to those anger. By holding on to those grudges, by holding on to these unforgiveness. It is time for you to be healed of your brokenness. And that's the only way you're going to receive the blessing that God has for you. That's the only way you're going to walk into the promised land that God has for you. You need to be whole. You need to be whole. You need to be filled with love. God is not a God of hatred. God is not a God of unforgiveness. So understand that if you want God to forgive you for what you've done, you got to forgive those that have wronged you. You want God to forgive you your wrongdoing? You have to forgive those who have wronged you. And that's how you're going to receive God's forgiveness. So that is why I forgive everybody. Because I want God to forgive me for everything that I've done. Because if I'm choosing who I want to forgive, then God is going to start choosing when he's going to forgive me, what he's going to forgive me. I don't want God to choose. I don't want God cherry picking when he's going to forgive me. I want God to forgive me of all my iniquities. I want God to forgive me of all my sins. That's why I forgive all my enemies. I forgive all those who have wronged me. I forgive all those who have violated me. I forgive everybody. I don't have time to be walking around with hatred. I don't have time to be walking around with brokenness. Life is short. I need to live life to the fullest. I need to live life with the joy of Jesus Christ in my heart. I need to have that peace that surpasses all understanding. I'm not going to be able to attain that level of joy if I'm holding on to grudges. I'm not going to be able to attain that level of peace if I'm holding on to unforgiveness. That is why I love my enemies. That is why I pray for my enemies. That is why I wish the very best for my enemies. Why? Because no one is worth my joy. No one is worth my peace. I want to receive everything that God has for me. I want to receive all the blessings that God has for me. So I'm telling you right now, the key to joy and happiness, the first step is to forgive all those who have violated you. Forgive all those who have wronged you. And that's how you're going to heal. That's how you're going to be delivered from your brokenness. So understand that we as a people, we are broken. We as a people, we are dealing with trauma. We've never healed. So what do we do in the black community when something happened in our family? We throw it under the rug. Jesus said, confess to one another so that you may be healed. So understand that. Address it. Address it. Talk about it. And then forgive. And then pray. And that's how you're going to be delivered. You don't dismiss. There's a difference between forgiving and dismissing. There's a difference between forgiving and suppressing. So no, don't dismiss. No, that's like putting a band-aid over a stab wound. No. If you have a wound, understand that you have to let it air out. That's how it's going to heal. So it's time for you to heal. And those of you who have those major trauma and you're struggling, understand that. Reach out to me. reach out. So we do counseling in this ministry. Yes, we don't play around with demons. We do not play around with the devil in this ministry. So if you're struggling with trauma, you're struggling with brokenness, so understand that we have powerful men of God that will counsel you. We have powerful men of God that will lead you and guide you through healing, so you could be the woman of God you are called to be, so you could be the man of God that you have called, you are called to be. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So it's time. We're at the end of the year already. 2022, what? It's almost over. It's almost over. You don't want to keep going in circle. You don't want to keep going in circle like the Israelites, where you keep delaying your blessing. You keep delaying your blessing. You keep delaying your blessing. And it's time. You wasted enough time. You know when you are driving a car, what happens when you make the wrong turn? The GPS say recalculating. You've been recalculating for too long. It is time for you to get on the path that God has for you and stop wasting time, so you could walk into your promised land, so you could receive the blessings that God has for you, so you could receive the elevation that God has for you, so you could receive the husband that God has for you, so you could receive the wife that God has for you, so you could receive the promotion that God has for you. It is time. You wasted enough time. You wasted enough time. It's time for you to get out of God's way, so you can receive what God has for you. It's time for you to remove your limitation for God. Understand that God is not going to take you to the next level while you're allowing your past to hold you hostage. Enough is enough. It's time for you to heal. It's time for you to forgive. And it's time for you to love, so you can receive the blessing that God has for you. And that's our word for today. And if you have not joined the ministry, I'm telling you right now, go ahead and DM us and join this ministry right now. So yes, you could go to the next level. Please if do. You are not part of this ministry, you need to DM us right now, so you can go to the next level. So you could be the man that God have called you to be. So you could be the woman that God have called you to be. So you could be the husband that God has called you to be. So you could be the wife that God has called you to be. A lot of you understand that it's not because you're not beautiful, you're not a wife already. You have demons that are tying you up. You have spirit husbands that are there to stop you from becoming a wife. And your pastor don't know how to deal with these situations. Your pastors don't have the knowledge to deal with these situations. They don't know about the incubus, succubus. They don't know about the marine kingdom. They don't know how the spiritual realm works. So you'll never be able to receive the breakthrough, the guidance that you need. So you need to join a ministry like this that don't play around with demons. No, we slay demons over here. So go ahead and join this ministry right now if you're not already part of this ministry. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We have Bible study on Zoom this Wednesday. Whatever you do, do not miss Bible study this week. It's going to be a life-changing, eye-opening Bible study. So understand that you need to get the information to the Zoom Bible study on Wednesday and be on Zoom at 8:30. At 8:30. So join this ministry. Join this ministry. I will see you Wednesday at 8:30. And that's our service for today. That's our service for today. We are happy to be back.
Amen.
We are happy to be back. It's been too long. We are happy to be back. Oh, we are happy to be back. And God is moving in a monumental way in this ministry. We're about to get back into the prison. Yes. So that's where I started my ministry, in Rikers Island. So we are coming back. We're going back to the prison. And we're not just staying in New York. We're going to be in Georgia. We're going to be in upstate. We're going to be in all over the country, going into the prisons, doing the work of God. We have powerful men of God in this ministry. Brother Jeff, Brother Michael, you know, that are doing the work of God fearlessly. Fearlessly. The devil's in trouble. The devil is in trouble. So go ahead and join this ministry.
Yes.
Go ahead and join this ministry and make sure you meet us in Bible study on Zoom at 8:30. That's our service for tonight, guys. Have a Holy Spirit filled week. God bless you. I love you, but Jesus love you much more. Good night.
Praise God.
Go ahead, woman of God. You have another announcement?
Yes. Appalachian American on TikTok with like a prayer for his mental health. He struggled with that for years.
Appalachian American. Okay, Appalachian American. We would gladly do a prayer for you before we go. But understand that you need to be part of a ministry that's going to combat these demons. So understand that we are going to pray for you. But go ahead and DM us and join the ministry and make sure you know you get to Wednesday night Bible study and reach out to me personally. So I deal with these. I specialize in spiritual warfare. I specialize in those demonic attacks. So go ahead and set up an appointment for a one-on-one session with me. So let us pray. He's dealing with
mental health.
All right, so this prayer is for Appalachian and anyone else who's dealing with mental health issues
and demons. Connor wants to accept Jesus Christ.
Okay, all right, Connor. So we're going to definitely close out with Connor accepting Jesus Christ as his personal Savior. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So let's go with the prayer request of Appalachian with mental health demons. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, Lord, we lift everyone, Heavenly Father, Lord, who is struggling, who are under attack with demons, Heavenly Father Lord, that is attacking their joy, that is attacking their peace, that is attacking their mental stability, Heavenly Father Lord. You say, Lord, you do not give us a spirit of fear, but of love, power, and sound mind. Amen. That is part, Heavenly Father Lord, of the package when we surrender to you, Heavenly Father Lord. So I'm speaking mental stability over the lives of every individual that fall under the sound of my voice, especially Appalachian. I speak joy, peace, a peace that surpasses all understanding over the lives of every individual that fall under the sound of my voice. I speak healing from all trauma. I speak healing, Heavenly Father, from all brokenness. I speak healing, Heavenly Father, from all mental and physical abuse, Heavenly Father, over the lives of every single individual that fall under the sound of my voice. Hallelujah. Oh Lord, give them the peace, Heavenly Father, that only you can give. Our strength, Heavenly Father, is our joy in you. The devil is trying to rob us of that joy because he knows, Heavenly Father, when we connect with the joy and the peace of Jesus Christ, impossible becomes nothing, Heavenly Father. That what activate our faith, Heavenly Father. Now we are able, Heavenly Father, to surrender and align with you, Heavenly Father. So he wants to rob us, Heavenly Father, of that peace. Allow us, Heavenly Father, to surrender and trust you wholeheartedly, Heavenly Father, Lord, so we can receive everything that you have for us. Heavenly Father, I cast out all spirit of heavy-heartedness, oh spirit of sadness, oh spirit of despair, oh spirit of depression, oh spirit of suicide, I cast you out in Jesus' name. I speak healing, joy, peace over the lives of every single individual that fall under the sound of my voice. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
amen, amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
All right, we had one person who wanted to accept Jesus Christ. What's the name of that individual, please?
The name of that individual is Kate Connor, 1980 on TikTok.
Kate?
God bless you, Kate, yes.
Kate Connor. Woo! Kate Connor. Kate Connor wants to accept Jesus Christ.
DM us, Kate.
Kate. Kate Connor. All right, Kate, we are going to pray for Kate. Kate, we are going to pray. This is what it's all about, Kate. Yes, Brother Mingo. Yes, people are getting saved. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Kate, God is moving in a monumental way. The Holy Spirit is moving in a Hallelujah. Monumental way. So that's why God is sending us into the prison system. So Brother Michael Mingo is part of this movement where we're going to be doing God's work in a global scale. So Kate, we're going to pray for you right now. We're going to have you do a prayer of salvation, Kate. A prayer of salvation. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, Lord, we lift Sister Kate before you, Lord.
Yes, Kate Connor.
We lift Sister Kate Connor before you, Heavenly Father, Lord, who wants to surrender her life to you. She's done things her way, and she's seen the result. But now she wants to do it your way. She executed her plans. She's seen the result. Now she wants to step into and walk into your plans, Heavenly Father, Lord. She wants to surrender her life and her soul before you, Heavenly Father, Lord. She wants you to be her Lord and Savior. For that, Lord, we glorify your name. We know the heavenly kingdom is rejoicing right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We glorify your name, Lord, for writing Kate Connor's name in the eternal book of life. She belongs to you now. Now Kate Connor's life is under the management of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
So therefore, no generational demons shall have authority over her life. No generational curses shall have authority over her life. No unclean spirit will have authority over her life, because now she will be led and guided by the Holy Spirit. So we glorify your name, Lord, for this moment. That's what it's all about. So we thank you for the salvation of Kate Connor. Hallelujah. So Kate Connor, I simply need you to repeat after me this simple prayer. I simply need you to repeat after me, Kate Connor. Lord Jesus Christ. And if you are not saved, you can repeat this prayer also with your hands in the air with Kate Connor. Lord Jesus Christ, I am aware that I am a sinner. Lord Jesus Christ, I surrender my life and my soul to you. Lord Jesus Christ, do with me as you will. Lord Jesus Christ, I am yours and I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Do with me as you will. Use me to glorify your name. Use me to expand your kingdom. Use me and execute your perfect plan over my life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. And amen.
Amen.
So if you repeat that prayer with Kate Connor, understand that your life belongs to God now. You're not your own anymore.
Praise the Lord.
So that means that anyone who has a problem with you, they don't have a problem with you. They have a problem with God. You belong to God now. So understand that. So now God is going to guide you. So understand that now that you belong to God, your best days are ahead of you. Because now God is in control. Now God is going to execute his perfect plan over your life. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. So all of you who are here, lift Kate Connor in your prayers.
Yes,
Kate on TikTok. Connor.
Yes.
So she just said, gave. Yes. She just gave her life to Jesus Christ.
Praise the Lord.
And the rest of you who are not yet in this ministry, go ahead and join us. All right? So we're going to be in the prison system, not only in the men prison, but also in the women prison. Yes. All over the country. So God is moving in a monumental way in this ministry. And I praise God for every single one of you. So do not miss Wednesday Bible study. It's going to be a life-changing, eye-opening experience.
Yes.
So go ahead and join this ministry and DM us and make sure you're at Wednesday Bible study on Zoom at 8:30 p.m. And that's our Sunday service, guys.
Praise God.
That's our Sunday
Kate
service.
Kate said yes. She just accepted Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And she's asked a question. Can I tell my friends about my decision about accepting Jesus?
Absolutely, Kate. Absolutely.
Amen.
Tell your friends. Tell your enemies. Tell your strangers. Tell your family. Absolutely. Let everybody know, Kate.
Praise the Lord.
Let everybody know. God bless you, those who are on YouTube. God bless you, those who are on TikTok. God bless you, those who are on Instagram. And we will see you guys Wednesday on Zoom at Bible study. Woo! God has been moving in a monumental way on Bible study on Wednesday. So you don't want to miss it. You don't want to miss it. Tell everyone. Tell everyone. We will see you guys on Wednesday on Zoom at 8:30 for Bible study. That's it. We got to go.
Praise
we got
Lord.
To go.
Praise the Lord Jesus.
We got to go. Yes, Sister Tracy, angels are rejoicing right now.
Yes, because so tell Kate a friend. Connor accepting Jesus
yes,
Christ.
Yes, yes.
Congrats, Kate.
So we're praising God for that. We're praising God for that. So we will see you guys on Wednesday at Bible study on Zoom at 8:30 p.m. sharp. All right, guys, have a Holy Spirit-filled week. God bless you and your entire family. I love you, but Jesus
loves
you much more. Yes. Good night.
Good night, good night. Seed Vij said there's a party in heaven. Amen. Praise God.
Yes.
Good night, guys. God bless.
DM to join the ministry. DM to join the ministry.
DM to join the ministry.
DM to join the ministry.
Yes.
DM to join the ministry.
Join us for Bible study on
Wednesday
night at
Wednesday.
8:30. And invite friends.
Yes. And we got discipleship class on Saturdays for those of you already saved already.
Amen.
Yes. And we'll be back here next Sunday, same time, same place. We're a little late today, but next Sunday is going to be 8 o'clock sharp.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. 8 o'clock sharp.
Amen.
See you guys next Sunday.
Have a blessed night.
See you guys on Wednesday's Bible study. I love you guys. Woo! If you're going to bring somebody next week, drop some fire emoji before you head out of here. If you're going to bring somebody next week, because you got don't come alone. You got to bring somebody. Drop some fire emoji. Drop some fire emoji if you're coming with somebody. If you're coming to Bible study on Wednesday, you're bringing some friends with you. Drop some fire emojis. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Drop the fire emojis if you're coming to Wednesday night Bible study on Zoom. Let's go, let's go, let's go. All right. Good night, y'all. DJ Majesty, you know you gotta wrap the service up, DJ Majesty. You know you gotta wrap the service
up. I'm jamming because Kate accepted Jesus Christ. I'm hyped.
We'll be back Wednesday.
We'll be back
Wednesday. You know you gotta wrap it up, DJ Majesty.
Jesus is love.
Yes, he is. DJ Majesty trying to do an overtime.